The girls are good. They're back home. Brought them home on Saturday. But when Coach Brown talks about playing D, when I heard that you hear the letter D, I think about diapers now. So when he says play defense, I'm like, oh yeah, that's right, defense.
How is that changing going on? How is that fatherly duty? It's only been like a week or so, all right? Come on, what's been going on?
It's been good.
Can you peek into the house?
It's just tough to be up every 2.5 hours. It's hard to feed, change, swaddle. Never heard of the word swaddle before, but now I have this, you know, like taco wrap or like a burrito wrap, and it's all stuck. And I guess it's good for the kids, so hey, I'll keep doing it.
Derek, is he capable of being a father?
I'm not quite sure, but I think he'll do just fine.
It's fine. Hey, and by the way, thank Mike again for letting you miss 2 games for the birth of your daughter.
Thank you, Coach Brown, for allowing me to not sleep.
It's a no-brainer, isn't it?
You know what? It's great. It's cool listening to Mac whine and complain up here. But let's give it up for the true person in this whole thing. I don't even know if she's here. But
Ashley?
Let's give it up for Wifey. Let's give it up for Ashley.
Ashley.
Ms. Capono.
Ashley.
Jason really hasn't done anything. And you know, we kind of let him go just to do nothing and to support his wife. That's why he's gone. Now he's back. Now he's working a little bit harder than what he was when he was gone.
Josh. All right, man. What's going on? What's going on with the Sox? Everybody wants to know. What's going on with the Sox? That's Michael Cooper. You're throwing back, man. You're the white Cooper.
Okay.
Yeah.
One Sox at a time. I don't know. It wasn't really that big a deal to me, but I guess people have noticed.
Has it always been like that?
No, I think I started doing it a couple of years ago, maybe every once in a while. Just kind of, that's what they gave me in my net before the game, so that's what I go with now.
Matt Barnes, what do you think of that look?
I like it.
You like it? I like it a lot. And a lot of people have been getting to call you McRambus. Yeah, McRambus. All right, you know, do you know the lore of, you know, Kurt and what he means to this community here in Los Angeles?
A little bit. I'm starting to learn more as I go. I think it's a good nickname for me because I've been called much worse things.
So such as?
I can't repeat them
yes,
on stage.
Can.
I think at least people can say it around my grandmother and she won't get too upset. So I appreciate it. And I know he was kind of a blue-collar guy in the way he played. So I think I can do similar things.
JJ, you look like you wanted to say something. Feel free to chime in, any of you.
Well, yeah, I mean, I'm thinking that since he has, like, that name, that we should bring back, like, the short shorts for him so he can play that role, right, to the fullest. You guys say that we should bring back the short shorts? There we go, see? In support.
You know, I just got a question. I hear the McRambus comparisons. You guys help me out. Did Kurt jump as high as he jumps?
We're gonna tell Kurt to say.
And we watched film today, and during the film session, I put that clip. Everybody see that dunk by Josh, that met us from that alley oop. And I mean, you clap. He's good. Now we're sitting in our film session, and it's pretty serious in there. And Kobe just kind of, I think was it Kobe that said it? Kobe just goes, "Wow, the game is changing. I've never seen a black guy throw an alley-oop to a white guy before." and we all thought about it, and then we busted out laughing because it was true. And he caught it backwards, too, and dunked it. Looked real easy.
Hey, by the way, he'll bring back the short shorts when you bring back the headband, Capono. When's that coming back? When's that head? That was sweet looking. Luke, what'd you think of the headband, the days of the Jason Capono headband?
Reminded me a lot of the Sasha Wuyu chick. Jason, I think he should bring it back. We had some good battles back in the day when he had the headband on.
Derek Fisher. Yeah, exactly. First of all, how you doing, man? You're rounding back into shape. I heard you say the other day that it's more mental than physical right now after the summer. And by the way, I'm sure, why don't you thank everybody for coming back again to support the Lakers after what was going on all summer long. Because I know it means a lot to all of you guys
that, I mean, fans are coming back in droves and filling arenas and watching record numbers right now.
Yeah, I mean, that was the most, you know, challenging part of the whole process, you know, during the lockout was knowing, you know, our fans have been, you know, so supportive and really drove this business to the levels of success that we're experiencing right now. And so to not be able to single-handedly, you know, do something about it, you know, there wasn't a way to just snap a finger and get a deal done. And so that was extremely frustrating. But, you know, we're here now, and like I stated last night, it's, you know, it's just a great feeling to see the fans coming back and showing their appreciation just for the game of basketball. That's pretty much what it comes down to. I mean, players change, teams change, but fans just love to see guys compete hard and play with passion, and, you know, that's what we're trying to do.
You know, speaking of which, whether you were, like, an owner's on the owner's side or whatever, or the player's side, does he have like 100 suits? How good was he looking every time he came to the podium? I mean, come on. Is there like a better spokesman? What were you guys thinking? What were you guys, look, what were you thinking every time you saw him going up there? I mean, obviously you wanted to know, but this is like, this is your boy right here.
No, Derek did a great job. He sacrificed, you know, our off season is short, and it's, you know, the only time you really get to spend with your family, and Derek sacrificed all that for the league and for us players. So, but you're absolutely right. He is the sharpest dressed man. I told him today, he saw Capone and he was mad because like he's never not the best dressed person wherever we go. And tonight, J-Cap got him. So he was a little upset about that, but he represents us nicely.
AC, don't worry, I'm getting to you soon. I'm getting to you soon. You're down there just all quiet.
I'm enjoying it all. I'm taking it in, enjoying it.